Amen.
Nuko mwene data wa ndangije kunakira yavuze.
As my brother who welcomed us just said.
Ntuye Michigan.
I live in Michigan.
Amazina yanje banita Kawaya.
My name is Kawaya.
Irindi ni Pascal.
Pascal.
Mugigi.
Mugigi.
Data itwa Semakangata.
My father is named Semakangata.
Nuwa Budutira.
My grandfather's name is Budutira.
Ngo Umunyabyinshi.
I am Umunyabyinshi from the clan of Aramazina.
Atagira waza kongorera ngo se nuwayitwa itubwirize.
Therefore, everybody knows me. I don't want everybody to keep asking their neighbor, who is he? Where does he come from? That is introduced.
Ikindi kandi ndashimira bene data batumiye mu giterane hano.
Again, I want to thank everybody that took the time to invite me.
Bateguye igiterane.
They planned this event.
Noneho baratumira.
And they invited me.
Ndabashimiye Imana ibahumugisha.
I thank you all, may God bless you.
Ikindi kandi.
Another thing.
Ngeze hano naho kandi banyakiriye neza cyane.
When I got here, they welcomed me with a warm welcome.
Ngeze nyine ngagahinda.
Like a little baby.
Ko bamfashe rero.
They welcomed me like a baby.
Niko bamfashe.
They are treating me like a little baby.
Tudatwaye umwanya munini.
Without taking so long,
tumaze gusomana ijambo ry'Imana.
We've read the word of God here.
Mu gitabo cy'imigani.
From the book of Proverbs.
Aha bavuga ko iki gitabo cyanditswe na Solomoni.
The Bible studies say that this book was written by Solomon.
Gusa bavuga ko hari ibice bibiri bya nyuma.
They say that the two last chapters.
Hari undi mugabo bita Ramuweli nawe waciyemo imigani mu bice bya nyuma.
There is another man called Ramuel who said some wise words in the two last chapters.
Noneho ubundi abanya Bibiliya cyangwa abateolojiya.
The people who learn about the Bible, the theologians,
baza bavuga ko igitabo cy'imigani kirishobora kuba ari mu bitabo bigoye kubwiriza.
They say that the book of Proverbs is one of the hardest book to understand and to preach about.
Kubera ko ni imigani.
Because these are wise words. These are proverbs.
Kandi imigani.
And proverbs.
Ahantu izigorera.
Where it comes difficult.
Nuko buri muco ugira uwayo migani.
It's because every culture comes with its own proverbs.
Mu bwoko bwacu.
In our culture, tribes.
Tugira iyacu migani.
We have our own proverbs.
Umuzungu anciriye imigani y'iwabo.
An American has their own proverbs, and if they tell me their proverbs, they do not match with our proverbs.
No, kubera buri gihugu na buri karere gafite yacyo mico.
Therefore, because every territory or every nation has their own proverbs,
no, bakagira, they have their own culture.
They have their own culture.
No, bakagira kandi n'imigani nyine itandukanye.
And therefore, of course, they have different other proverbs.
Nico gituma wenda muri iyi mico y'Abayuda.
It's therefore because in the Jewish cultures,
kubigira mu mico yacu imigani murayumva yinduzuga utayumva neza.
Translating these proverbs from the Jewish nations to our cultures is not easy to understand.
Noneho bigatuma bishakugora.
It makes it difficult to understand.
Kandi sinsubira mu mateka yacu.
And I am not going to spend more time in the history of our culture.
Ngo kivuga gutya ngo igice cya mbere ngo ngere kuri 31.
To name every chapter and the purpose of its writing.
But ntabwo nabisha mucho.
I won't spend time in that.
Gusa abashakashatsi bemera ko harimo amagambo y'ubwenge.
But the people who do research do say that there is a lot of wise words.
Kandi akomeye.
And very strong word immediately, present time. Those who search me early will find me. I will compare this with the prophets of Isaiah. Where Isaiah says that, look for me while I'm able to be found. Because there is a time you might look for him and you won't find him. Sometimes God is good at hiding. The reason why I tell you that he knows how to hide, even those the holy people, the righteous, he might even hide to the righteous, from the righteous. And they look for him, they
Job,
he said that I looked for him in front, didn't find him. And I said, let me look to the other side. I didn't find him. To the right side, I didn't find him. When I faced the left, I didn't find him either. And I said, where are you found? Where did you go? May you please come. And if you come here, I have something to tell you. The righteous people can sometimes not find
them.
I want to tell you about Abraham. He looked for God and didn't find him. Jesus himself didn't find God when he looked for him. He didn't find him. The last thing when Jesus was on the cross. So he said, okay, now that you've let this happen to me, now I surrender my life to you. Wherever you are doing, my life, my soul, I surrender to you. If you take wherever you are hiding, if you come and I might find you, here, I give it to your hands. That's why when the Bible says search for God, search for him when it's still time, when you still have a chance. Because God knows how to hide. He's good at hiding. People start questioning, where did you go, God? A songwriter said, sometimes he looks like he pretends to not listen to you. He pretends like he's not with us. He lets you and do not think that you are so much of a worth in front of God. Let me ask you this. Today and tomorrow I'm going to talk about three things, but today I will only tell you one. Something that shows that you love something. What shows that I love him? What shows that I love God? Your time. It's your time. When we talk about searching for God, it's not about going and removing this carpet and looking under this carpet and all these speakers looking underneath them, looking in the hiding places, trying to find. No. No, that's not how it's done. Let me tell you this. You have come today to worship. You are here in this place.
for God. It's not coming down under the carpets and pillows and everything. No. Your time. It is your time that you love. Some people even go all the way till six. Never sleeping, spending all the time
with God.
When you love God, when you are searching for God, you spend your time for Him. Please forgive me. Let me talk about time a little bit. Time is a period of time.
Yes.
A certain period, a measured period of time. Now it is easy to talk to or to mention it. There is a research that I did before the people started timing things. The invention of time, of clock. Before they invented a clock, before they knew about it, 60 seconds is a minute, 60 minutes is an hour, 12 hours, before they knew that 12 hours was a day, before they knew that 7 days is a week,
and
before they knew that 30 days is a month, before they invented it, before they knew about all that, it was difficult to know the time. I was reading, doing this research and saying they do think that is
Egyptians.
Towards the year of
350.
Before Christ, B.C. 3,000 years before Christ. That's when they invented time. They do not know the person. All this division of
times, days, weeks, months,
and years, all this chaos was not found yet.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you love spending time in the bars, you spend. When you love bars, you spend time in the bars. Let me tell you this. I'm going to ask Brother Ntwari to read for me in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10.
Yes.
Chapter 6, verse 10, book of Ephesians.
No, 5 and 10.
Chapter 5, verse 10. Book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 10.
Dividida por Mushakashake.
Ukomami.
Mushakashake, ukomaminya, ibyumami ashima.
Try to find out what is pleasing to the Lord. Let me tell you this. Finding God, looking God, what the Bible says, I love those who love me and those who search for me. Searching for God, it's not going through a valley and you go to the hills. We are pastors, we were cattle rearers. During the summertime, cows would go astray. Those who were born during the time when we were not owning cows anymore, they do not know what impogazi
is.
Impogazi were the kind of cows that spent time on the mountains. That's why we said that.
Impogazi.
impogazi
ni tegutyo natwe turatwita iradio radio televizyo turatwita impogazi zari inkatwagaza dushira ku musozi nzizitahe
kinds of cows that we didn't really care about. They would spend nights and days in the mountains. And men would go after 2 or 3 days a week to go and look for them. To just look how they are doing. Just see how they are doing.
He
would see, look and all those kind of names of cows. And he would see how in the Miragabo is doing. And he would know that all these impogazi are here. Once he would not find a certain cow, he would go find it. He would spend a day and come back in the early morning. And they would ask, why did you spend a lot of time there? And he would say, such cow I didn't see. And he would come to the other family members and say, hey, I didn't find this cow, look for it. Those who are shepherds, they do know how to follow the footsteps of cows. We would ask a certain person that we were meeting on the way, and they would say that we can't find our igaju car.
It
has the horn. And you will tell this guy the car. And he will tell you that that certain cow that I saw yesterday, the day before yesterday, you cannot look for God the way you would look for a car. You would not go to the valley. You would go to the mountains. And you would ask William where God was found. No, no. Are you searching for God? Spend time with Him. Spend your time with God. God will know that you love Him. He will know by your time how much you love Him. The time you spend with God, don't ask God, do I love you? Just the matter of spending time. Spending time with Him. And don't care about anything else. Just spend your time with God. And once you spend your time with God, do not question how much you love Him. Because He knows that. It defines itself. That's how we search for God. We spend time with Him. You spend your time to God. This is why when He gives you a gift to live, you should spend your life with God. We know what English people say, spending time. I'm going to use about 3 terminologies.
Spend time.
Save time.
Waste time. Manage time.
Let me ask you. What is wasting time? Let me tell you something. He wasted his time for
king.
Don't we say that we wasted our time? Don't people say that? When you waste your time, what has been wasted? There is activities that could have been done, which were not done. And when that happens, we say that we wasted our time. Saving time, you divide your activities from the time that you have and say, I will do this during this time and do that during that time. You are saving time. Now,
ureke mubwire iyo ushaka iyo hayo ushaka shaka Imana. Ari yatsume ngo ushaka shaka kumenya ibyo Imana ishaka.
When you are searching or trying to find what is pleasing to God,
bo noneho ngiye guheza Imana.
Now I am going to offer to God
umwana
my time.
Ndash,
I'm coming.
Nigeze.
I come to God.
Narinje kuguha umwana.
I came to give you my time, God.
Wa mwanya.
Now this time
uraukore uraukoresha uraugira gute?
How are you going to spend this time in front of God?
Iyo niyo twita gukoresha umwanya.
This is what defines what spending time is.
No.
Now,
iyo ugeze hari Imana,
when you come in the sight of God.
Sorry, izivuga ngo tuyigereranye n'ikindi kintu.
God says that do not compare him with anything.
Ngiye akani mfasha nyigisho.
This is just for our
mfasha nyigisho.
So just to help us understand. This is just something to help us understand.
Bo uyigezeho.
You come to God.
No, uvuyiri ya muri za shift sinzi
wa rundi. You come all the way from your shifts, your work, daily activities.
Uraje trekanyeza kukanya.
And say I'm going to spend this time to God.
Uyigezeho muri
God. And you come to God.
Aho urayigera kugire gute?
What are you going to do when you come to God?
Uyigezeho.
You come in front of God.
Uyigezeho.
You come in front of God.
Tuyigereranye n'ikindi kintu.
Do not compare God with this metallic here.
Ndabiyam.
I warn you.
No, rahabese.
You come to God.
Uragira gute nuhagera?
What are you going to do when you come in front of him?
Ntabuntu wosubiza.
Anything, anybody with an answer,
you know,
when you come to God, what do you do? That's why some men kneel down. They say, I have come, oh God. I want to pray. I want to praise. I want to glorify.
Haba numugabo numukoga numwana numugore
numukunda wese yumugeza wa anybody when you come to the person that you love you do say something
uraga kubwira urukundo ziruza rwemera kubana numuntu ukunda utavuza
ka the person that you love without saying anything
sicho gituma turi mukwita bakecu bashiri.
This is why we call people honey sheri and all that
Hey, come
on. Isn't that true? Don't we call each other Sherry?
You kundu.
When you love a person,
uravuga.
You glorify them. You express your love to them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Mama ndagukunda.
Tell God that you love him.
Nicho kitumaje mbere ya masuya.
That's why I've come in front of you.
Mama ndagukunda.
God, I love you.
Wewe walinzi muryango
wangu. You protected my family.
Mama ndagukunda.
God, I love you.
Wewe wapaya kazi
yako. You give me a job.
Mama ndagukunda.
God, I love you.
Wewe wapaya watu.
You give me a good neighbor. God, I love you.
Wewe walinzi muryango
wangu. You created the world. God, I love you. You created the world. Now God, I love you because you've done good things to me. God, I love you because you gave me a car. God, I love you because tell God.
Hallelujah.
Tell God, let the words flow. Let the words flow from your mouth to God. We do not go to the mountains and the valleys in your own home.
Amen.
When I'm washing dishes in the kitchen or my job, with a song glorifying and worshiping God.
Have you ever
dreamt about a song and you spend the whole day singing that song? And when you worship, when you sing, you sing that song. When you think about anything, that song still comes to your mind. When you are about to eat, you still forget and sing the song before start eating. Hallelujah. Sometimes it's overwhelming. Hallelujah.
Let's raise up
our hands for the glory of God.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Tell God. Tell him that he created the heavens and the earth. And you tell him how merciful, how wonderful it is, his creation. And when you used to walk, and now you are driving your own car, tell him everything he's done for you. We are looking, searching for God.
Hallelujah.
With our words
no.
And spending our time with him. Time. Sometimes are good,
good,
and some bad periods. Have you ever lived during difficulties that you never even try to remember or
think about?
Even when you remember, you feel sad. Periods, times. And you remember sometimes, and you feel that you missed them. And say, I remember the old time, the way I used to raise up my hand, and you would say, your words are so powerful.
There's
sometimes when I remember and I feel that I miss them. And we feel so, we feel like we will start crying. We will start crying. Sometimes that we miss. Hallelujah. David said, when I remember the old things that you've done, I raise up my hands for your glory.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! I do have my own times too. I do have my own times that I remember. I do have times that I remember. I kneel down and I raise up my voice for the Lord. Hallelujah. I have times. Willie has his own times. And Rumilis has times that he remembers. And Manoah does have the times that he remembers as well. I remember, I kneel down. When nobody commands me to kneel down, when no law tells me to kneel down, I raise up my voice and my hands to the Lord. Sometimes I lay to the floor and I crawl down to the floor. Sometimes I spend the whole time, the whole day inside the house. Sometimes I do shout. Americans do like security. When you come to a house and you just start shouting, but when I come inside the house, when that comes to me, I come inside my car, I start driving to the highway, and I all shout all the way, and I go all the way down the road, shouting to the Lord. When I feel released, and I turn around, park my car in the driveway, and I say, this car is for me to glorify the Lord. I tell my car that you've helped me to have a private time, a close time to worship the God. When I worship the Lord in the house, they might call 911 on me. But times, you have those kind of times. Job, sometimes, when he was in the
difficulty,
he said that I curse.
Yari, the mama,
when my mom, I cursed the night that my
mother
David,
he cursed
the mountains of Jeroboam. Even one day,
I was asking the people that,
the people that live in Israel, they say that Gilboa is still a desert. David says that all the mountains of Gilboa, I'm cursing you. You will never. There's no rain that will come from heaven that will fall on you. Because that's where the blood of Jonathan was shed. He cursed the place. Do you remember what he had come? What had come?
Do
you remember the time of his love and Jonathan? The love of him with Jonathan. When he saw the place where he was laying and saw the blood, and he said, your mountains, because it is the place where all the heroes live. He said that I remember the love of me and Jonathan.
It
was like a tree that is
to
no one could separate with another. Hallelujah. Times help us to become who we want to become and to decline to become what we do not want to become. One man, he was a member of my church. During the time when they wanted to celebrate, he took alcohol and his two young brothers, they spent time in the bar and drinking. They even had extra bottles of alcohol and they took extra alcohol again and they kept drinking. When the alcohol was almost at the neck, three brothers were in the bar, started fighting, and people came to separate the fight. They went home. On Sunday he came. I told you that some times are good. The chest that he took to the bar had produced water for him. He was humbled when he came to the altar on Sunday. He came and said that I have come to repent. He told us about how he went to the bar with his young brothers. He said that ever since we were born and we grew up and we married, we have never fought with each other but the day we went to the bar.
But
he said, now the time that I spent in the bar, I repented. I will never go back to the bar. I will never drink alcohol again. What I cannot deny, when a bottle comes to from the bar, and the bottle comes and comes inside my house and opens itself and pours itself in my mouth. But if a bottle doesn't do that, until the bottle dies down, I will never go back again. I'll tell you the truth, even today. Where we spent time and everything that we did,
and
we would say that all the trash that I lived with, time
kigufasha kugaya,
helps you to decline, minimize,
no kukizinukwa,
and hate
kubera ibyo wagikoze,
what you spent,
kikaza nibintu,
it brings things back to your life,
kizinukwa kubera ibintu
wakoze, makes you hate everything that you did wrong with your time. And good times too helps you to be happy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Nicho gituma nkubwira ngo,
this is why I tell you this.
Nuja gushaka Imana.
When you go searching for the Lord,
yezigirira.
Spend your time with him.
Usabiye wabanye n'Imana.
The times that you spent with God,
nibyo byagize byakugize ukomeze.
So they defined who you are today.
Ninabyo bizakugira ukuzamya.
And they are still to define what you will become tomorrow.
Bo muri irigabanya ry'ibihe,
in this division of time,
tugira icyo twita past, ibihe byacu.
We know the past,
tukagira na present,
we know the present,
tukagira na future,
and we have the future.
Ibi bihe bitatu,
this three times,
ibyashize,
this three periods of time,
none,
both the past, the present,
nibizaza,
the future.
Ako kantu nzakagira ubwoye kukana.
When I think about that,
nguvuruka kwanje kubira ngo,
when I feel my flesh peeling off,
cyane yongeze muri mataro mugihe cyo kubabarirwa, cha forgiveness.
When I come to the matter of forgiveness,
sorry, nakandi ka topic ariko mundeke sino utata kavuze nzarwara.
Help me talk about this just for a second.
Imana iyo yakubabariye,
God forgave you.
Yababariye past yawe.
When God forgave your past,
ibabarira na present.
And he forgives your present,
ikababarira na future.
And forgives the future as well.
Kubera ku imbabazi zayo,
because his mercy
sees ubushize,
is not for the past only.
Kandi siza none,
for the present only.
Ureke kubwi,
let me tell you this.
Yo mana yanje,
oh my God,
iyo bari tababari ndutova avongo na babari.
Have you ever heard the singer say that I've been forgiven?
Nkuri nanje narababari.
I surely have been forgiven. We all were forgiven.
Turabanyabya.
We were sinners.
Igihano cyadufashe.
The punishment, the court has accused us or convinced, we were explained guilty, but we were forgiven. We were forgiven for our past, the present, as well as the future sins. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That makes me lay at peace. Hallelujah. I love God. I love this. Hallelujah.
Yesu ya neutralize imbaraga z'icyaha.
This shows me how the power of the love of God has neutralized the power of sin.
Nicyo gituma abantu iyo bataramenye igihe bababariye.
That's why when people do not understand when the time of their forgiveness,
bazabagira ngo bababariwe ejo bundi.
They only think that yesterday or last Tuesday was the time when only when they were forgiven. Don't you know that Jesus has been here for more than 2,000 years? In the book of Ephesians, he chose us a long time ago, the Bible says, before the foundations of the world were put in place. And he called us, and he made us righteous. People that will inherit the before you was born,
na ibataravuka
you was forgiven before
iyo mistake
born
ubwo bwiru power yaravuze ngo
this mystery is overwhelming. God
coming in form of a man. That's how it is for a sinner to become righteous. It is
a mystery.
It is a miracle for God to make himself a man.
It is a miracle
for a sinner to be made holy, a righteous man. It is a miracle.
Yes,
may God bless you.
That's it.
I am going to pray. God, the powerful God, in the name of Jesus Christ, may you bless this congregation. Everybody that's here today, may they be blessed. May we know how to look and search for you. May we know how to spend our time with you. May we know how to redeem our time for you. May we give you our time.
Let's all kneel down.